Welcome back. I hope all is well. I'm glad you're here. Today we're going to talk about simple practice. Actually, we're going to talk about how to make simple practice more simple. That's right. You know, I edit a lot of videos and I see a lot of videos on YouTube all about like 5 hacks to make Premiere Pro work better or Photoshop hacks, all sorts of hacks for different applications. But I don't see many videos about hacks for simple practice. Maybe that's because there are no hacks. And I'm not actually going to share with you any hacks today, but I want to share with you 5 things that make my work within Simple Practice more effective, more efficient, and more productive. I think these will be helpful for you as well. So that's pretty much it. I want to share them with you. Without further ado, let's jump in and let me share with you these things that make Simple Practice more simple. So here we are in Simple Practice, and the first thing that I do that makes my life so much easier is by combining windows into groups of 2 so I can look at a whole bunch of different windows all at the same time. Let me give you an example. When I'm in my intake, I often have multiple windows open at once. So the first thing I'll have open is the intake note, right? So it'll look something, it doesn't look like this, but let's just pretend this is the intake note. It'll look like this, you know, it's a note. So that'll be open, and then I'll have to look at the chart for other information, which is right here. And then perhaps I'll do a mental status exam, which is a separate chart. And then I have a whole bunch of others. I do something called the Columbia Suicide Severity Scale. That's not even in Simple Practice. And that's over here, it looks like this. And so usually what I do is I'm flipping back and forth, looking at this document and going back to the note and typing something in and then going back to this assessment and filling it out, just really cumbersome. So what I found out is you can actually split screen multiple windows all at the same time. Let me show you. So we have 4 different windows here, right? And we're gonna group them in pairs of 2. So I'm gonna pull this one out, I'm gonna pull this one out, and now we have 4 windows and they're all separate, they're not just tabs, right? And so what we'll do is we'll go to the note and we will hold the green button down. This works for Mac. You're gonna hold that green button down, tile window to the left. And then I'm gonna go ahead and choose one of my options right here, right? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take the other window, we're gonna hold it down, we're gonna pick a side, we're gonna choose the 4th document. And now what we have is 2 full screens, all with our documents on them, right? So instead of having 4 windows, now we only have 2. And you can pair these however you want. This makes my life so much easier, right? So now I can look at the note, I can do the mental status exam, or I can do the suicide scale, and I can look at the intake. Really, you can combine this however you want. Really, really awesome. It makes things so much easier. So kind of working off that little hack there with the split screen, another thing that makes my life very easy is by keeping a list of commonly used phrases and different things that I use over and over again. So for example, I use CPT codes, right? These are codes for insurance companies, for different services that you provide. And so I have made a list of different phrases. And so what I can do now is split screen my list of commonly used phrases and my template or my simple practice documentation, whatever it is that I'm working on. And I can go back and forth and I can just simply copy and paste. So if you haven't started yet, go ahead and collect a database of commonly used phrases, codes, things like that. Split screen and go ahead, copy and paste. You will be working so much faster and more efficient. So another thing that speeds up my workflow in Simple Practice is by adding different events and different things that I need to remember into the calendar. So if you click on a blank space in the calendar, you have 2 options, client appointment, which is pretty obvious. It's an appointment for the client, or other. I don't really know exactly what this is for, but I would imagine from events and things like that, whatever is not a client appointment, right? Things that don't need to be billed. But I use this for anything that I need to remember. So for example, let's say I need to write a treatment plan for whoever, right? I put treatment plan in there. And what I usually do just to help me remember is I will put it at 9 a.m. for 60 minutes. And then I'll go ahead and I'll push done. And so now what you'll see is I have a reminder in there. Now the thing about this, and I've made a video about this before, which I'll link up above or down below, this is not like as high tech or efficient as like a Google Calendar. So we have to kind of work with its limitations. A lot of this has to be manual, but this really helps me because you're looking at this calendar every day. This is what you log in and see. So if I make a reminder in this way, it's not gonna go off, it's not gonna be an alarm, but I can see it here. So it says treatment plan, right? And what I can do then is I can just simply move it around just like this. And so let's say on Wednesday, I don't actually get it done and I need to do it the next day. I'll just take a look and I'll slide it over. And I'll do that however I, you know, however many times I need to, with whatever event or reminder that I need. I find that this really helps me. And then when I get it done, I just come over here, I put in done, and that's it. I don't touch it anymore. But I really like that. You can drag it around, move it around, and the reminders are always stacked up in my 9 a.m. slot every single day. So I get a look at them and I don't miss them. So another thing that speeds up my workflow is by making sure that the default session auto-populates to my most commonly used codes and fees. So let me show you what I mean. So let's say, for example, we need to schedule an appointment on December 1st. You're gonna click the blank spot. You're gonna open up this window and you're gonna go to create client appointment. You click the client. And once you click a client, all this stuff auto-populates. So you see here 90834, which is a very commonly used code for 45-minute therapy, that popped up automatically, and so did the rate of $100. Now, this is all hypothetical, but let's say, for example, yours is different. Your rate is not $100, let's say it's $50. Now, because it's not set to default, you would have to type in 50 and then push done, right? And you'd have to change this each and every time you scheduled an appointment, because the 45-minute 90834 and $100 is auto-populating every time. But we can fix that. If we go to settings, and then we go to billing and services, and then we go to services, we can actually go over here and we can choose our default. So let's say, for example, the 90834 is something we want to keep as a default that's already set, but we want to change the price. So we're going to go in and we're going to go ahead and let's change it to $50. We're gonna go ahead and just push save here. And there's a whole bunch of other parameters that you can change as well. But we're gonna change that for now, right? Now let's go back to the calendar and let's schedule a new appointment. You're gonna click the client and then boom, $50, 90834 pops up. This actually saves a ton of time over the long run. So the final thing is not so much something to improve productivity, but I want to show you how to customize the widget that Simple Practice gives you that allows you to put the client portal link on your website or the scheduling portal on your website, right? So what you're going to do, we're going to go to settings, and then we're going to go to widget, and then we're going to look over here. And so you're going to see this big line of code, and you're going to go ahead and copy the code. And essentially what this does is it allows you to paste it into your own website. So I use Squarespace. And so what you would do, you have that code pasted and you're gonna see over here that this pops up. It's the widget, it says request appointment. And then the widget actually, this is the scheduling that pops up. I don't have any slots available, but this would allow someone to book an appointment right from your personal website, which is pretty cool. Now it's orange and it says request appointment. Now, I don't know if you can fully customize everything. I'm sure you could if you look into the code, but I am no one who codes. I don't know anything about coding, but I did figure this out. So if you see here, you go into the code, you can actually take a look. And if you scroll all the way over, you have to look for this, but it says request appointment right here. And this is actually the title of the button. Let's say you want to call this just simply schedule to make it a little more clean. You would delete that code and you would put that word in there, close. And there it is. Now it says schedule, right? It's that simple. Let's go ahead and test it out. And boom, it works just like that. So now you can customize the words on the widget. I thought this was pretty cool. So that's pretty much it. That's five things that make my life in Simple Practice a bit more simple. I'd love to know, are there things that you do inside Simple Practice that make it more simple, more effective, more efficient? I'm always looking to learn, and I'm sure other people are as well. Put whatever you do down below in the comments. But until then, I look forward to seeing you soon.